That's Ian Blair talking after the verdict and the fine came in for the Metropolitan Police yesterday. Now, I'm delighted to say that we've been joined by Andrea Perry, crime reporter and former crime editor of the Sunday Express. And you were just listening there to what Ian Blair had to say. What do you make of his attempt at a defence there? Wasn't that resolute a defence, was it?
No, not at all, really. And all the way along, he hasn't been, I think, particularly overly apologetic for what happened. He does come across often as quite arrogant, really.
And what do you make, in general, of the press coverage? We've been saying that it's extremely bad for him today, isn't it?
Yeah, I mean, it is extremely bad, but he doesn't sit... I mean, he's quite resolute in his, you know, determination to stay as the commissioner. It's something that he obviously coveted for some time as deputy to Lord Stevens. And I can't really see him, you know, resigning. He is a political animal, and he's got the support of the government, and he's also got the support of the MPA chairman and
the
also...
The Metropolitan Police Authority.
Yeah, the Metropolitan Police Authority, and also Ken Livingstone.
Yes.
And at the moment, that is the support that obviously he needs if any of those fall away.
Yeah.
I know there's this emergency meeting that's being called next week by the MPA, which could change things, and also we've got the IPCC report coming out in the next few days, which again could change things.
So more pressure to come.
Exactly, yeah.
Well, the only paper that came the nearest, really, to giving any sort of support for Sir Ian Blair was the way The Sun reported it this morning. They say met guilty over shooting of de Menezes. But then the main headline here, you see, is verdict could mean terror gangs go free. Furious cops last night warned terror gangs could escape scot-free after the Met was convicted under health and safety laws over the bungled shooting of Jean-Charles de Menezes. The jury's verdict, after a trial costing taxpayers £3.5 million, was slammed for giving bombers a new loophole to dodge arrest. Angry officers claimed robbers and kidnappers would also be gloating that the killing of the Brazilian, mistaken for a suicide bomber, was deemed to have put public safety at risk. But if the Met thinks they're going to get any support from The Sun in its leader column, they'll be a bit mistaken, because it's a bit ambivalent. The leader, the editorial column, says Met chief Ian Blair was, they seem to have stripped him of his knighthood, but never mind, was right about one thing concerning the death of Jean-Charles de Menezes. No police officer set out that to shoot an innocent man. But, says The Sun, they must not be handcuffed by ludicrous health and safety rules. But Sir Ian Blair seems to have misinterpreted yesterday's court verdict. The judge did indeed stress no individual is responsible for this sad mistake. But that means the buck stops squarely at the Metropolitan Police's Police Commissioner's desk. Sir Ian insists he won't resign, nor should he yet. However, it says it was Sir Ian's decision to put the reputation of the whole Met police force on the line. It has been damaged, but it will survive. It remains to be seen if the same can be said of its chief. So, Andrea, rather lukewarm support, if one might call it that, from The Sun.
Well, they seem to be hedging their bets. But I thought there was a good point made by the chief crime reporter that Sir Ian was the man who made the decision against quite a few colleagues' objections that they should plead not guilty to their health and safety charges. And it seems to me that they, you know, they were never going to win the case. There were so many communication failings and failings over intelligence and surveillance that they really should have, like, really put their hands up to it. And I think that it would have been a different story. Maybe there wouldn't have been the resignation call. You know, he needs to, like, face some facts over this particular case.
Now, the trial has fed the sort of news pages, because lots of information's come out. Just tell us briefly, there's more points to come, isn't there? There's the potential inquest, there is the inquest to come,
yeah.
And then the IPCC full report. Just tell us briefly what's to come.
Well, the IPCC obviously have had to hold off publishing their full report because of the various illegal actions that were going to take place. They have said that in the next few days the report's going to come out. I don't know whether it is going to be the final report, the full report, because obviously we've still got the inquest.
They told us today it'll be in the next few days.
Oh, right, that the inquest obviously is going to probably won't take place till next year, and that will again, I'm sure, raise a lot of legal matters. I mean, it will be the chance really for the family to be able to take on a number of officers who maybe haven't faced any...
Now, we're fast running out of time, but Asad, I just want you to tell us very briefly about the Forest Gate case and perhaps a sign that the Metropolitan Police hasn't changed that much. Just tell us briefly what happened.
Well, the first gate raid that took place literally actually on the anniversary, near enough on the anniversary of Jean-Charles' death, the following year, when the police raided a house in Forest Gate and shot a young man who, again, they believed was involved in terrorism, and it was hauled off, and it was massive in all the media. Again, the Metropolitan Police had leaked to all the media the severity of this case and how dangerous these people are, and it ended up being proved that none of the family were involved, that the fat police had gone in very, very heavy-handed, had shot an innocent man. And, you know, it was, again, one of the big criticisms of Sir Ian Blair. Subsequently, after all of the embarrassment over that affair, we now hear that the two brothers were, again, the victims of an armed police action, where they were dragged off their motorbikes, machine guns put to their head, so saying, shoot them, because the armed police were in the area thinking that somebody had in possession of a gun. We now know that it was a young child with a water pistol, and then realised that these two brothers were the same two brothers that had been shot a year before, and I think it's okay. Just very embarrassing.
We've obviously been dominated by the Domenez's case today, but Sarah, I just want to quickly ask you, we've got very little time left, but this piece in The Times, Hillary's choice, be a bully or delicate flower. What's this all about? Tell us in about 30 seconds.
It's just a fun comment piece that the Democrats just do not know how to deal with Hillary, because if they take her on, they look like bullies, and if they don't, she can wipe the floor with them. And so they compare this to the behaviour of Elizabeth I, who also used her feminine wiles in the same way. And the conclusion is that you cannot fight a woman.
How do they do it then? What's the trick?
There's no answer. I think that's the beauty of it. So it ends by saying this is why Hillary will win.
And of course, you used to edit the Sunday Telegraph. I mean, unusual to have female editor of a national paper still in Britain. I mean, is that difficult for a woman to do compared to for a man? Are there peculiar difficulties over a man doing the job?
I can't see the difference, because I don't think it's quite the same. So I don't think you're having the sort of stand-up rise in the same way. But had I read that article, I might have known to resort to tears.
You might have learned a few lessons.
when it was crucial.
Not that being the editor of the Sunday Telegraph is quite like being the president of the United States.
No, exactly.
It's probably much harder. Anyway, I'm afraid we're going to have to stop there. We've run out of time. But let me thank our guests, Sarah Sands of the Daily Mail, Asad Rahman of the Justice for Jean Family Campaign, and Andrea Perry, a crime reporter who managed to make it in. Thank you for watching. You can see the repeat at 23:34 and 3:35 GMT. Please email your comments to bth@presstv.co.uk. That's bth@presstv.co.uk. Tune in tomorrow for the BTH Weekend Edition with Jan Fosgaard. And please join me on Monday, same time, same place, for another edition of Between the Headlines. Good night.